certainly the Blackhawks are focusing on taking one of these two games here. You'd like to take both, but I don't think that's realistic. I think that if you're going to take one, in my opinion, it's probably going to be game four. If you do want to talk game four a little bit, Hawks have been able to adjust to what other teams have done. So they kind of get a feel for what's going on in game three. Then they make adjustments and they come hard in game four. But it'll be very interesting to hear what's going to happen at the arena. I was just talking to Steve about that. Haven't been at TD Garden here since 2011, and it was a regular season game. So I expect it to be loud. I expect the energy to be great. I'm looking forward to comparing it to what's going on at United Center.
You know, a lot of visiting teams will play the road game of we'll just check for 10 minutes and let the home team wear itself out. But what's really troubling is you don't know. I don't know. Maybe you do, Chris. You're around them. I don't know which Hawks team we're going to see.
Right.
And we've seen many different Hawks teams in the finals already, and it's only been two games. I know it's been even the overtimes have required overtimes, but they've been wildly inconsistent from period to period, and I worry that it's going to be shift to shift because they tried playing tough and that didn't work, and then they played a skating game, and they finally ramped that up, and it worked for them. They came out and played a skating game, and they just died in the second period from then on in game two. Either no legs, no brains. When they got hit, they stayed hit. They weren't playing smart. They were not the dominant team. I know the Bruins have something to say about it, but I'm troubled by the Hawks' inconsistency from game to game, period to period. That's an issue, and it may be they're going to Boston and just settling in for the first period and going 10 minutes without giving up a goal might be the best thing for their focus.